Hello, 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 nursing student. This is Dr. Luine for your NCLEX review. Now, if you have ever failed NCLEX, if you feel depressed, if you feel frustrated, and you don't know what to do, you want to give up, let me tell you something. With Dr. Luine, you don't have to give up. I'm here to help you pass your NCLEXism in your own language. The number to call today, the number to call Dr. Luine for your NCLEX review, guys, is 561-319-4660. Now, I have good news for you. Now, if you feel like everybody else out there, you've been fooled by them and you never been able to pass your NCLEX exam. They give you a lot of content, they give you a lot of money without any explanation. Guess what? In your own language, Dr. Luine is here to help you pass your NCLEX exam. Now, there is no game. If you want to pass your NCLEX in your own language, let's say that you speak Creole, only Creole. Yes, I have a group for you. Now, if you speak only English, I have a group for you. Now, if you speak Spanish also, call Dr. Luine at 561-319-4660. If you speak only English, call me at 561-319-4660. Now, si vous parlez créole, relevez-moi dans 561-319-4660, guys. I am the number one instructor. Not only I am a doctor, I have the medical knowledge, like I said, and also have the nursing knowledge. There is no comparison. I am a doctor, and also, of course, I am a nurse. It's like I'm saying that I'm a nurse and I haven't taken the exam. Yes, I've taken the exam, then I know what it is. Like I said, I have the algorithm of NCLEX exam, how to pass NCLEX. I know how to help you pass NCLEX exam. And your own language, if you speak Creole, you Haitians out there, and you speak Creole, you watching this video, this is for you. Call me at 561-319-4660. Now, I'm going to give you guys something today. I'm going to show you how do I teach my students to pass NCLEX. I have hundreds and hundreds of Haitian students who pass NCLEX with 75 questions. No, that's not a game. Now, if you want to pass NCLEX just like those students, now with no struggle, with good tactic and good strategy, this is the time to start. What are you waiting for? Call Dr. Luine at 561-319-4660. I'm gonna show you, I'm gonna give you a demonstration tonight. I'm gonna teach you, I'm gonna show you how do I teach the content. I know my content and I know the secret how to pass your NCLEX exam. Tonight I'm gonna be speaking about electrolyte. One of the most electrolytes you need to know for your NCLEX exam is the king potassium. Potassium is one of the electrolytes most tested in NCLEX. And I do have tactics and strategy to show you. Don't stop struggling out there. Stop being fooled around. Stop getting a lot of content and books and stuff, and then never explain them to you. They give you, they charge you a lot of money, and then never being able to explain them to you. I do know my content as a doctor, and I can explain them to you. Now, let me show you. Let me give you just a little demonstration now. You know what? Potassium is very important. Like I tell my students, take note. Take note. You know what? Put note in that. What is the electrolyte? The first thing I tell my students, you cannot talk about potassium, calcium, sodium, magnesium if you don't know what is electrolyte. What does it do to your body? Now, listen. I'm gonna show you. Now, after that demonstration, do not waste your time. Do not waste your money out there. Call Dr. Luine, your Haitian instructor, the best and the best of all instructors out there. Now, I don't talk for talking. I know what I know. Now, let me tell you something. Now, what is electrolyte? No, that's an abnormality. Electrolyte is an abnormal change abnormal in the level of your electrolyte into your body. What happens is when you have abnormal electrolyte like potassium, sodium, calcium, or magnesium, what happens is you can have too little or you have too much electrolyte. Well, what happens? That can cause cardiac disease or cardiac problem or cardiac failure. That's one thing. Now, another problem you may have when you have electrolyte disturbance, you may have kidney failure, you may have liver failure, you may have all those major organ failure, and you may have also water intoxication. Now, one of the things you need to pay attention in English, like I tell my students, you need to pay attention to fluid imbalance, because all the exam has to do with fluid imbalance. So you need to know when to assess. The question is, the key point in English is, what do you do as a nurse? What should you assess when they're talking about an electrolyte in the exam? Now, let me give you just a little demonstration to show you now. Now, one of the electrolytes you need to know is potassium, but you have also sodium, calcium, magnesium. Now, the key point, listen, the key point, what do you do when they give you one of each electrolyte I just mentioned to you? Let me give you the tactic now. Now, whenever they say potassium, as a nurse, pay attention there, I'm coming there. This is how I explain my students. When they give you potassium, the most important thing to do as a nurse, potassium, what is that? What potassium has to do in your body? Now, potassium has to do with your heart rate as a nurse. Now, whenever you see potassium in your NCLEX, you need to assess heart rate. Come on now, this incident. You need to assess heart rate. That's the first electrolyte you need to pay attention to. Now, the second one is calcium. You can't go to NCLEX without knowing your calcium. Now, calcium has to do, listen to that. Whenever you see question about calcium, what do you do? Answer for me. Let me give you 1 second, 2 seconds to answer the question. When they give you calcium, what should you do as a nurse? Now, as a nurse, whenever you see calcium in a scenario, you need to assess the bone problem, or you need to assess muscle problem. So, patient may have bones weakness, patient may have muscle problem or the disability problem. So, for example, one of the questions most tested is about osteoporosis. Be careful with that. Now, this is calcium. Whenever they give you magnesium has to do with, in general, about varicine. So you need to assess vital sign. You need to check if your patient is alive or not. You need to double check your patient. So that's electrolyte magnesium. Magnesium has to do with your vital sign. Now, if they give you sodium, you need to know sodium. Now, every electrolyte I just mentioned to you, nursing student, you need to know the normal range. You cannot answer the questions in English if you don't know the normal value for each of them in English. Like I told my student, whenever you study an electrolyte, a lab value, what down the normal range in top of your notebook. This is what you do. Now, sodium has to do what? What should I do as a nurse when they mention sodium? Now, sodium has to do with that. Now, whenever they say sodium, as a nurse, you need to assess for fluid imbalance, fluid problem. Now, it may be fluid deficit or it may be fluid overload. Now, this is a key point. Now, I tell you what to do when it's potassium. Now, I tell you what to do when it's sodium, calcium, and magnesium. This is the first point. If you don't know what to assess as a nurse, how would you answer the question in English, guys? This is how I teach. Now, listen to that. You need to know the normal range for potassium is 3.5. Write it down on the top of your notebook. 3.5, 5.1. Or you do the reverse way. 3.5 to 5.3. That's potassium normal range. Now, if they give you calcium, you need to write it down on top of your notebook, which is calcium. Calcium is 8.6 to 10.1. That's calcium. A lot of lab they may give you based on those lab, the value may change. Don't worry about that. Make sure you know this value I just mentioned to you nursing today. Now, let's go with magnesium. Magnesium, when they give you magnesium, you need to pay attention. What is the number ones with magnesium? Do they give me magnesium? Do they give me calcium? Or do they give me sodium? So now, if you don't know the number range of magnesium, how would you pass any test? Let me tell you now. Put down, write it down. It's 1.6 to 2.6. That's magnesium. Now, for sodium number range, it's very easy. 135 to 145. That's the number range for sodium. That's the very first part when you. Once you're looking at, once you're reading a question in your NCLEX exam. Now, let me tell you that potassium. What is potassium? Potassium is one of the key electrolytes you need to know because you assess the heart rate. Now, what happens is when they give you the sign and symptom, that's what you gotta pay attention to. Now, potassium has to do, when they give you a question about electrolyte, you need to know when the electrolyte is abnormal, how do you call that? For example, if potassium is abnormal, the problem is kalemia. Oh, let me say it again. Let me say it. Pay attention, nursing student. My nursing student. When potassium is abnormal, or has an abnormal range, either low or high, what happens is the problem is kalemia problem. So now, what happens is kalemia may be low, the problem may be low, or the problem may be high. Now, when the problem is low, they call it hypokalemia. Okay, then see. Okay, because I'm coming for it now. When the problem is too high, when the value is too high, potassium, they call it hyperkalemia. Now, therefore, whenever they give you an electrolyte, you need to pay attention if they say low, if they say high electrolyte. Now, whenever they say low, the tactic I give my students, whenever they give you an electrolyte like potassium like that, you need to pay attention to the prefix. That means the beginning. That means the beginning of the problem. The beginning is hypo. Now, therefore, hypo means low. So all your signs and symptoms will go low. There's some exception. Now, if they say hyperkalemia, all the signs and symptoms will go high. There is some exception also. Now, pay attention, take note. Whenever they say hypokalemia, you're gonna have signs and symptoms that gonna go low, but the urine output and the heart rate of your patient will not go low. Pay attention to that. Whenever they say hypokalemia, you're gonna have all signs and symptoms, most of them, they're gonna go low, but for the urine output and your heart rate, they're not gonna go low. That's the one of the exception. Now, instead of having bradycardia with low potassium, you're gonna have tachycardia. Instead of having decreased urine with hypokalemia, you're gonna have increased urine output. Now you need to know the normal range for urine output. There you go. You need to know the normal range for your heart rate for to answer this question. Pay attention. For example, let me give you two examples. For hypokalemia, I'm gonna have surely hypotension problem. Yes, I'm gonna have hyporeflexia problem. I'm gonna have the patient gonna go slow, lethargy. Even the EKG, because the one of the key points in this question when they're talking about hypo or hyperkalemia, you need to pay attention to the EKG. Even the EKG, and I gave the tactic to my student, you need to pay attention when they give you an EKG, the word, the vocabulary in this question, if it goes low, if it goes low or not. Now, for example, I'm gonna have a short T wave, short P wave. I'm gonna have a depressed ST. You know, interval. Now, those are the tick. Whenever they say hypo, everything goes low. But you're gonna have tachycardia and I increase urine output. Now, pay attention to that. Hyperkalemia does the same thing. You need to pay attention to the prefix. They say hyper. So hyperkalemia means everything go high. Most of your signs, they go high. Except urine output and the heart rate. Now, with hyper, hypercalemia, remember that for your NCLEX exam. You're going to have bradycardia, which is decrease your heart rate, and you're going to have oliguria or decrease urine output. Now, you can't go to NCLEX if you don't know the normal range, like urine output is 30 mL/hour. You need to know that, guys. Now, this is hypercalemia. Remember, if you have hypokalemia and you have hypercalemia, pay attention. Which one is your quality? Come on, nursing student. Your quality is the one that goes high. Hypercalemia is your quality nursing action in the NCLEX exam. Your quality is hyperkalemia. Remember, with hyperkalemia, you can go just like that with a heart attack. Cardiac arrest. Now, this is how. Now, the key point to remember the sign symptom of those, hyperkalemia, call it, because it's the one that's going to kill you first. So, therefore, call it killer. Or if you don't want to call it killer, in order to remember it in your NCLEX exam, call it murder. Why I call it murder? Because when you murder somebody, that's very bad. And potassium can murder you just in a second. Now, murder, let me give you the last one to remember. This is how I tell my student to remember it. Murder. Potassium, when you high, you are murder. If you are in a murder, so therefore, what is M? What is U? What is R? What is D? What is E? What is R in NCLEX? Don't forget, write it down in your book and your little board they give you in your exam. Now, murder means what? M stands for muscle weakness. Muscle weakness. Then a urine, remember I told you that that's the opposite, that goes the opposite way, that goes to the opposite. Now, urine, so the U stands for urine output low. Hallelujah. Now, what is air? Air means respiratory distress or respiratory problem. Now, D stands for decreased cardiac contractility or decreased cardiac heart rate. Good job. Now, E, what is E? E means EKG or ECG change. There is an EKG problem. Change. Well, that's what. The fact that they say hyperkalemia, the EKG gonna go like that. High. Remember that hyper. I mean, I'm gonna have tall people, pity river, ST elevated. This is how I remember it for my NCLEX exam. Now, what is R? The last letter M is R. R stands for reflexes go high. Reflex go high, which is hyper. Reflexia. This is how I remember my sign symptom for hyperkalemia. Remember, hyperkalemia is your priority, and hyperkalemia is a murder. The fact that it's a murder, write down murder on your board, and you get the answer in your select order that applied. Remember, this is just a little demonstration about only one electrolyte, potassium, the king potassium. Now, remember, always assess the heart rate. This is how I teach my student all the content. I don't just read the content. I don't just get the book like that. Oh, listen guys, all right, let's go to page 1000, page 200. I don't do that because I know my content and I know the secret of NCLEX by knowing all my content. I don't go to send you to read on Sunday's Kaplan U-word. I don't do that. Because doctor is a doctor. I know my content. Stop being fool. You has Haitians. If you know me, if you see, if you pass by, you watching this video, I am Haitian like you. But I know my content as a doctor. That's what I do with you. Just call me now at 561-319-4660. Let me tell you something, guys. If you want more videos, I'm going to tell you that. Stop sharing my videos to all of you guys. Stop sharing my videos on Facebook, YouTube. I'm gonna put this video on Facebook and also on YouTube. Share, like, follow me. If you wanna if you want me to put one or two videos every single week for you, share. I need more subscribers. I need to do it very seriously now, guys. Because I want my Haitian community to know, and I know the American community to know about me. I'm gonna be teaching, I'm gonna be doing the videos only in English for you, all of you guys. If you speak English, if you speak Creole, I'm gonna do that. Now, follow me on Facebook, Luine NCLEX Review, on YouTube, do the same. Luine NCLEX Review. Now, follow me. I need more Lord, I need more and more subscribers on Facebook and on YouTube also. Now, if you want me to put in a little video like that, guys, encourage me like I'm encouraging you right now. This is Dr. Renee. This is your number one instructor. And I do teach all your content. I do know all your content for your English exam. I know for all of them, there's always a way. There's always a tactic or strategy to know and to remember your content. If you don't do that, you do nothing. 561-319-4666. See you next time for another video, guys. Ciao!